Welcome to the Shore Spring Band Concert. We are going to start this evening's program with the jazz band. As a courtesy to our musicians, we ask that you take a moment and silence your electronic device. Thank you for coming, and we hope you enjoy the program. This group is currently has 7th and 8th grade students in it, but when it first started, I had to get some 6th graders and 7th graders and 8th graders, and it was about a group of 15. It was very small, but they wanted to learn the style and to have fun. So some of these kids in here started with me as 6th graders that are 8th graders. If you started with me in jazz band as a 6th grader in 2014-2015 school year, stand up or wave.
Thank you.
Hey, that's awesome. I mean, I could promote it, but they made it happen. One student really, really impressed me in particular the past 2 years. He came to Shore last year as a 7th grader, and I've never seen anyone as a 12 or 13-year-old play as well as he does, and that's Cameron Burton on the drum set. About a round of applause for Cameron Burton. Loves music like a lot of these kids do, and he works really hard, just like a lot of the kids do. But I'm so happy that they're in jazz band, and my 7th graders that are in here, I hope you do it next year. Nice job. All right. That last piece featured our wonderful flute section. Flute, stand up. Nice job, flutes. Before we play our next piece, Mr. Yole is going to come up and talk a little bit about summer band. I do the elementary band through summer in Mentor, and I absolutely love working with the kids. They get to play their instrument over the summer. But Mr. Yole started this, I think, 44 years ago, and it's still going strong.
Okay, be honest. There are parents out there that were in summer band with me when you were in school, so stand up. I'm going to see if you're here. There are some parents that were in summer band. So if you were in summer band last summer, you guys that are sitting down here, band members, stand up. I started summer band 45 years ago. If you were in summer band, stand up, please. Anyway, we started it because I was teaching at Hopkins and beginning a clarinet lesson, and there were three girls there, and the first lesson I sat down and I said, okay, get your instruments out, and two of them opened their cases and started putting it together. The third one didn't open her case, and I said, well, put your clarinet together. She said, I forgot how. So we had a staff meeting. I said, we have to do something to keep these kids playing over the summer and improving and having fun playing their instrument. So there's a summer band handout out there. It goes from May 30th to June 29th. 5 weeks of having lots of fun, am I right? We have a lot of fun playing our instruments. And we do some other things. Lindsay, what was your favorite part of summer band?
Probably like all of the fun activities, like the Fun Day Fridays.
They didn't know I was going to ask them anything. Okay. Fun Day Fridays?
Yeah, all of the contests and stuff, like Crazy Hair Day, Tie Day, and you just do like a bunch.
I just made my appointment today to get my hair done that week. It's true. Connor?
And first off, my name is Tyler. Thank you.
Oh, Connor? Favorite part of summer band?
My favorite part was the collection of the great musicians at summer band and how we all played together with all the fun songs.
Good answer.
Tyler.
Thank you. I enjoyed unbearable heat. No, I enjoyed the, I enjoyed the concerts that we play some of the songs that we play are just amazing.
You like the music. I like that answer too. Okay, you were in summer band last year, Ellen? What was your favorite part?
I liked going outside and playing kickball.
What was your favorite part of summer band? What did you play last summer? Flute. Yeah. And you're not playing flute anymore. You're playing the bassoon. Way to go. Did you turn your summer band form in?
What was your favorite part of summer band?
Probably the concert. I like the concert.
We have concert, we have kickball, we have all kinds of good stuff. Anyway, I want to protect your investment and keep these kids playing. That's why we do summer band, and we have fun. I'm ready. See, before we go sit down, I just have to tell you how proud I am of these Mentor teachers and the Mentor musicians. There was this contest here last weekend. If you didn't know it, there were five middle school bands, and all five got superior ratings. Aren't we proud?
Thank you.
I have been so impressed with what the 6th grade band has been able to do this year. Last year, if you remember, they probably just had their concert at their elementary school, and they were playing things that were a lot easier than what they're playing now. They're playing really hard stuff. They're doing it with really good tone quality. I want to recognize one student in particular for her work ethic this year. She had a little bit of, she struggled a little bit at the beginning of the year, but she worked really hard and she wanted to get better, so she sought out private lessons. So I wanted to take a minute and recognize Paige Thelman for a hard worker. All of these students work so hard, they are so much fun. Enjoy our last piece.
Thank you.
We had quite a few students in both 7th and 8th grade this year participate in solo and ensemble contests. If you're a 7th grader and you played either a solo or an ensemble, please stand. Yeah, percussion. Wave your hand, sorry, percussion. It's such an amazing opportunity to play either a solo or an ensemble because it gets the students a little bit out of their comfort zone. Instead of playing in a group of 50 or 60, they're playing in a group of three, and they're the only one on their part. So it's really my favorite time of the year because I get to see them grow more than at any other point in the year. There's a couple students that I want to recognize. We have a lot of great leaders in here. And one of my favorite things about working with this group this year has been watching them mature from 6th grade into 7th grade. It really is amazing what 1 year does, and all of them have matured so much this past year. But there's a couple of leaders in here that really stand out, and I want to take a second to recognize Brianna Burwell, Connor Trumbull, and Jack Webster. Their actions in rehearsal every single day. They were always prepared. They always had their music. And they're just all around great leaders. And they set a good example for their peers. Nice job, guys. Lastly, there were two students that really stood out this year that kind of went the extra mile. As a 7th grader, they participated in solo and ensemble contests. They took a solo, they played in an ensemble. They took private lessons. Every single day I would see these two in the morning, either playing their instrument or one trying different instruments. Always, always, always trying to get better, and they're really, really passionate about music. And I love working with them, like I love working with all these students. But like I said, these two really, really stood out this year. That's Lindsay Kintop and Vivian Clark.
Bye. Thank you.
Before they play their last song, as the 8th grade class, I want to recognize a couple of students that have shown great work ethic this year and for the past 3 years that I've had them. First, I want to recognize one section that really stood out this year, and since I've known them in 6th grade. They've grown together, they've pushed each other, they have worked so hard in the past 3 years, and especially this year, and I want to give an Outstanding Section Award this year to our flute section. Stand up, flute. Earlier they played for you the trio that they played at Solon Ensemble Contest, and they've just been working so hard the past 3 years, and I really couldn't be more proud of what they've done. Nice job. And finally, there were two students that really stood out since kind of 6th grade. I've actually known them since 5th grade because they did summer band with me as 5th graders coming in shore. This is the Director's Award, and it's for students who show excellent work ethic, excellent musicianship. They seek opportunities to better themselves by coming in and seeking help if they need it, seeking private lessons. These students played in solo and ensemble contests. They've been a jazz band for the past 3 years with me. They've just been such good leaders for the group. They set such a good presence in the ensemble on a daily basis. And I want to give this year's Director's Award to Zach Perrier and Matthew Melinda. Nice job, guys. Really, really proud of you. Really proud of this whole 8th grade class. This is my 3rd year teaching, this is my 3rd year mentor, so this is the first group that I had. So I learned a lot with them, and I've really enjoyed having them as my first class, and I'll always remember them as the first class that I took all the way through shore. So I really hope they continue on at the high school so I can see them in the marching band and the band program. Before we play our last piece, big thank you to all the Music Mentors people that you see here helping out. It's so much of a relief to know that I don't have to do this on my own. So thank you to them. Thank you to Paul Gatsky for setting up. Thank you to Doug Baker and Bobby Ingram. Doug Baker has been such a big influence on me this past 3 years, and he's been such a big help during my first 3 years of teaching, and we're really going to miss him here. How about a round of applause for Doug Baker? Thank you, Mr. Baker. Thank you, and we hope you enjoy our last piece.
Thank you.
all our musicians clear out before you start the auditorium. That would be wonderful. Thank you. Sixth grade, you can stand.